بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
Good morning and assalamu alaikum everyone. First of all, I would like to congratulate all the students for being promoted to your new classes and commencing the new session of 2020 and 21. Class 6 students are well aware with me. This is Ms. Farahman again teaching you English literature and hopefully to spend very good time together but in some different manner, that is through online way. Just to keep yourself and the surroundings safe. Okay, the book which we will going to deal is Oxford Reading Circle, Book 6, Second Edition. Oxford Reading Circle, Book 6, Second Edition. Again, we will going to read interesting stories together. Okay, now let's opening the book and have a look towards the first story. The first story is The Birthday Present. The Birthday Present, page number 9. Everybody open it. As the name indicates, this is something interesting which we all curious about it. Okay, before starting the story, let's talk about the author. What the author has planned, which sort of the mind is he having? The author of the story is Len Reedbank. Len Reedbank. She was an author of the children, especially. She used to write for adults as well, but she loved to write the stories which were full of adventures and magic. She loved the fantasy world. And she has written so many stories to grab the attention of the children. Let's see this story. Will going to grab your attention or not? Apart from writing effort, she was a journalist and an actress as well. And she has shown her adventurous and magical skills in the story. Let's talk about the story, how she has written. The story comprises of 6 characters. The main character was Omri, a little boy, on which the whole story is based. Then, the mom and the dad of Omri, Adiel and Galen, they were the brothers of Omri, and Patrick. He was the friend of Omri. What was Omri curious about? As the name of the chapter indicates, he was waiting for his birthday to collect, to receive some interesting gifts from the parents, from the siblings and from his friend. And after so many wait, the day came. When the day came, he received the most interesting gift from his parents. Yes, the gift which was received from mom and dad was the skateboard. As the boys usually love such things. So he loved to receive the skateboard. And he knows how to do the skating. In combination with the skateboard, the brother Adiel gifted him helmet to keep himself safe while doing skating. These two gifts made him more excited to receive the next gifts. But some unfortunate thing happened to him that the other brother, Galen, had gifted him old metal cupboard that was taken from old streets. Why he gifted so? Some tragedy had happened with the Galen as well. Some unfortunate accident happened to him that he was had an accident from the bicycle of his dad that wounded him badly and damaged the bicycle. That made the dad angry and he stopped giving him the pocket money. So he was not having enough amount to purchase something new for the boy. So anyways, Omri managed to receive and then he went to the school. There, from his friend, what gift was he received? He received a red Indian man old toy that was no more of the use of the Patrick. That made the boy sad and upset. What was that toy? You can see on page number 10. This was the old toy that was gifted to Omri by Patrick. He was feeling sad, but he was not showing his feelings to Patrick. Why? Obviously, it might hurt Patrick. Anyways, he managed to pass the day and came back to the home. By looking at the boy, mom realized that something happened to him. He was feeling upset and sad. Obviously, mom has such sense. Everybody's mom are having the senses that they could realize if something good or bad happened to you. In the same manner, Omri's mom realized that something happened to the boy. Well, she asked and Omri showed. Well, mom was thinking to do something interesting for the boy that could make him happy, as all of us moms used to do. Anyways, the mom brought an interesting key to him. 12, page number 12, you can see. This was not an ordinary key. This was the magical key. Board with a red ribbon, and she asked the boy to place anything in your old metal cupboard and lock the cupboard with this magical key. Actually, this magical key was gifted to mom by the grandmother of Omri. And Omri did the same. He had placed his old red Indian toy into the cupboard and locked it. And he was waiting for something surprise to be happen. He was not able to sleep at the night to see what will going to be happen. But which surprise he will going to get. Anyways, he managed to sleep, and when he woke up in the morning, he was hearing some sounds of shouting and jumping from the metal cupboard. When he opened the cupboard, what he saw? That toy was converted into the real Indian man. The toy was converted into the real Indian man through the magical powers of the key. And that red Indian man would having some magical powers, whatever wish he could do to that man, he was going to fulfill. Wow, how interesting it was. And that made him happy. In this way, the ordinary birthday gifts, the ordinary birthday presents become interesting through some magical powers. That is all with the explanation of this. Just imagine if something ever gifted to you that was having magical powers and that could do anything for you, how do you feel? Let's share your answers. How do you feel? Well, if it ever happened to me, I will feel pleasurable. And I will going to ask so many of my wishes to fulfill. Anyways, that is just to grab your attention. The story is just based on the magical powers. But what is the moral of this story that the author wanted to convey? She wanted to convey that never become upset and disheartened by little things. You have the potential to attain anything in your life through the magical powers which is inside yourself. Only by doing efforts and only by hoping good. That is all with the explanation of this chapter. Now moving towards its word meanings that you will have to do in your copies. How you will do, I will explain it later on. But first, understand the meanings of the words. Let's open page number 9. The first word we are having, appreciate. The word appreciate means to encourage someone to do something. Coming towards the next page, basin. It is the bowl for washing we used to have in our washrooms. Regret, feeling sorry for something. Florence, it is the name of a city that is in Italy. Scrabbling, to scratch something. Petrified, feeling frightened. And undoubtedly, without any doubts. Alright, that is all with the explanation of this. Now I will going to explain you about the work, how you will do the work in your copies. First of all, you will make the title page of first term, then the title page of chapter number 1, birthday presents, along with the page number. Okay, now on the next page you will have to write the day and the day, the heading of the chapter number 1, birthday presents, page number, Then the word meanings by drawing the column. Either you can write the words with the black pen or blue, it's up to you, but the meanings should be written with a blue pen in a very neat and clean manner. Then you will turn the page. The next task which you will have to do is to write about an unfortunate accident if ever happened to you. What does it mean? It means that it's mentioned in the story, some unfortunate accident happened to the Galen. He slipped off from the bicycle and got wounded and so on. In the same manner, if ever you got an accident from the bicycle, from the bike, from the car, either from the stairs, you slipped off from the stairs, either you slipped off from the stool by cleaning something, any sort of the accident, if ever happened to you, you will have to describe it only in 5 points or 5 lines in the form of paragraph if you are writing. Okay? The work should be in a very neat and clean manner. The work should be in a very neat and clean manner. And no correction pen will going to be used. The work should be submitted on the given time. And if you use the correction pen, so the work will not going to be accepted. If you have any queries and any questions, you can ask on our WhatsApp link. The work is also uploaded on our WhatsApp link. That is all with this class of English literature. Stay connected. We will going to have the next class of English language. Thank you.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
Assalamu alaikum to all my dear students and good morning to all. I hope that you all are doing well. First of all, I would like to welcome you all in our new session 2020-21. This is me, Ms. Fazila, and I am going to teach you English language of class 6. And the book which we are going to have, that is the grammatry. Okay. And the topic which we are going to have, that is really easy, and that is on page number 1. Can you see it clearly? Okay. First of all, let's come towards the board. I have written the definition and the kinds of noun over here. Before telling you regarding the definition, I want to tell you something more, that the topic which you are going to have, that is basically noun. Okay, that is basically noun. What is noun? Nouns are the names of people, places or things. Okay, we can say like that as well, that nouns are what? The things which are around us, the people which are around, who are around us, okay? The places where we are living, these all are what? Noun. Definition I have written on the board. Nouns are the names of people, places or things. Clear? For example, Rehan is a good boy. In this one example, in this sentence, what is noun? You can find easily. Rehan, which I have underlined, okay? Rehan is what? Noun. Why? Because in the definition, I have told you that this is the people name as well. Okay? So, this is what? A person name. This is what? A person name. So, this is what? Noun. For example, if I say, I have a book. I have a book. This is the thing name. If I say, I have a marker. This is also a thing. So these all are what? Things name. So these all are what? Noun. Okay. Let's come towards the kinds of noun. Kinds of noun I have mentioned over here. Kind number 1, common noun. Number 2, proper noun. Number 3, material noun. Number 4, countable noun. Number 5, uncountable noun. Again I'm repeating, common noun, proper noun, material noun, countable noun, uncountable noun. In the common noun, basically what we discuss? We discuss the place's name, we discuss the people name, we discuss the things name in a general way. For example, I have written on the board lady. This is what? If you cannot see, I am speaking again and again, I am reading again and again, lady. The example of common noun is lady. Okay? Now, I have not mentioned a name of a lady. Lady can be your mother. Lady can be your sister. Lady can be your teacher. Okay? I am not telling the particular name. I am talking in a general way. In a general name. Of a general name. Okay? So this is what? Common noun. Next is what? School. Next example is what of a common noun? School. School can be any school. I am not telling you the name of the school. Okay? School can be any school, the educator's school, the smart school or any other school. But I am not telling you the name of the school, okay? This is why school is the common noun. Okay, now let's come towards the proper noun. Proper noun is what? In the proper noun, we discuss the particular things, particular name of the people, okay? Particular name of the things, particular places. In the example, I have written Rida. Okay. Now let me know, in the class, 25 girls are sitting.
Let's suppose this is a classroom, okay? In this one class, 25 girls are sitting. So I cannot say to all the 25 girls and I cannot call them Rida. I can call only one Rida, okay? Whenever you guys are using a particular name, okay, that is what proper noun. Let's suppose Karachi. If I say city, city is what? Common noun. Why is common? Why city is common noun? Because I'm not telling you the particular names of cities like Karachi, Lahore, Islamabad. Okay? If I tell you the names of the cities, those all names are what? Proper noun. But if I only say city, school, lady, these all are what? Common noun. Both kinds I hope that you are getting. Now third is what? Material noun. Common, proper, third is what? Material noun. Material noun is really easy. If I have a, okay, forget about the definition. Let's come towards the example first. This is what? Gold. I have written gold over here. Okay. By the gold, we can make the jewelry. We can make the rings. We can make the earrings. We can make the necklace. Okay. So, the noun by which you can make the other things. Okay. This is another noun, gold. And by this, you are making the rest of the things. So, this is what? Material noun. For example, wood. By the wood, we can make the chairs. By the wood, we can make the doors. By the wood, we can make the desks and windows as well. So, this is what? Material noun. Because this is being used for making the another things. Clear? Now, second last is what? Countable noun. Countable noun and the last is what? Uncountable noun. We are going to discuss them. Just listen it carefully. I have a marker. I can count it. One marker, two marker, three marker. I'm counting countable noun. Let's suppose if I say water bottles. Bottle number one, bottle number two, bottle number three. I can count them easily. If I say pens. Pens I can count, but if I say this is countable noun because I can count it easily. But if I say the ink which I have filled in this marker, I cannot count that ink. Okay? I can only measure that ink because this is a liquid form. The thing which I want to discuss with you people, that is what? The liquid form. Okay? Ink I cannot count, I can only measure. Water bottle. Bottle I can count, but water I cannot count. Okay? If I say that countable noun and uncountable noun, the example which I have written over here, pens. I can count them. Pen number one, pen number two, pen number three. I have told you before this. Similarly, the ink I cannot count. Okay? Oil. Oil is uncountable noun. I cannot count that. The explanation I have given to you, that is all. But now, let's move towards the book. So that you can get the topics easily. Take out the page number 1. Page number 1. Can you see it clearly? On the page number 1, there is a definition of a common noun and a proper noun. I have told you each and everything. Listen, names of any person, any place, animal or thing in general, as I told you. Okay, example, lady, school, cat, fan. These all are the general names. Okay, this is the common noun. Proper noun. Can you see it clearly? Proper noun. Names of particular person, places. Names of particular person, places, animals or things. Example, Rida, Kohat, Jupiter, Oreos. These are the particular names. I cannot call all the girls Rida. I cannot call all the places Kohat. Okay, and Jupiter and the Oreos are the rest of the examples. I hope that you are getting easily. Now let's come towards the page number 2. page number 2. Okay, we are having on the page number 2, you can see here. On the page number 2, we are having the different kinds, but I told you about the material, countable and uncountable. The first one is over here, countable noun. Countable noun. A pen can be counted and can be used as singular. A pen or plural, sixpence. Example, coin, coins, notes. Okay, you can get easily. Uncountable noun, as I told you, they are also called mass nouns. We are having the two names of the uncountable nouns, mass noun and the uncountable noun. They refer to liquid substances and ideas, oil, plastic, milk, honesty. Okay, the last is what? Material noun. Can you see it clearly, beta? Okay, these are the names of substances from which different things are made. As I told you about the gold and wood, we are having the rest of the examples over here, like sand, sugar, gold, butter. Okay, by these all things we can make the different things. This is why they are basically called the material nouns. Okay, that was the 5 kinds of noun. I hope that you are getting all the kinds. Let me know you one thing. In this one topic, we are having the rest of the kinds, but we are not going to read right now. We are not going to study those all kinds right now. Okay, I have told you the 5 kinds and I have given you the homework regarding these kinds. How to do the homework? Let's come towards the page number 3. Page number 3. Pick out all the countable and uncountable nouns from the sentences below. We are having the 10 sentences. You are supposed to copy these all 10 sentences in your copy and skip 2 lines after each sentence. And in those 2 lines, you are supposed to solve that exercise. For example, there is a sentence, the supermarket is quite close to our house. You are supposed to copy these all sentences and solve out. Then let's come towards the page number 4. You are having 15 sentences, but you guys will copy only 5 sentences. Number 1, 3, 5, 6, 7. Again, I'm telling you 1, 3, 5, 6, 7. Any kind of remover, correction pen, you are not supposed to use. Okay. First of all, make the first term title page. Then make the title page of the topic. Mention all the kinds in the title page. Okay. Then do all the working. Copy the definitions in the copy of 5 kinds and do all the exercises which I have told you. If you will guys find any kind of issue, you can find all the things regarding your homework and the explanation in our web portal. Okay, till then, take care and Allah Hafiz.